When the IPL started, I was very passionate about cricket. That I used to draw all the logos of the teams and players and everything. So I've always wanted to be there, and it's just a start for me, and I'm really happy for that and very grateful.
Your first IPL, your first season with the Kolkata Knight Riders. Tell me about the anticipation that a player, a young player, has ahead of a season of the IPL, because this was going to be your first time. What were some of the thoughts that were in your head at the start of the year?
Firstly, I was very surprised. Actually, I didn't expect it. And all these years, I have been dreaming of playing in the IPL and everything. And obviously, playing with all the stars now, like a coach like Brendan McCullum, all I have seen is him on TV. So it was going to be a special thing for me, and hopefully it happens soon.
Tell us about your auction story. When the auction was happening, when KKR picked you, where were you? Were you watching TV? What happened immediately after?
We had a Ranji Trophy match on that day, and we just came to the hotel, I think. And after that, I was watching the auction. I didn't see my set of auction, so before that I was watching. I didn't know my set was coming there, so I had gone to take a bath and something like that. And when I came, as soon as I came, I thought, let me watch some movie or something like that. And I didn't know that my name came and I was picked by KKR. One of my teammates told me that I was picked by KKR.
Let's talk about the start of your cricketing journey. You grew up in Indonesia. There's not a very big cricket environment there. Were you as passionate about the sport growing up in Indonesia as well?
No, actually my dad used to play there. So looking at him, I got the interest, and I started playing there only. And after that, my dad thought it would be nice if we can switch to India and start playing there like professionally or something. Initially, the thing was, even everyone would have done that, just play for fun, how is it going, enjoy cricket and everything that. And after I started to play for the state and all, it became a career for me. I started to think professionally about it.
And when you started playing, you obviously had a lot of interactions with Dinesh Karthik, not only in Tamil Nadu, but now also at the KKR Academy that you were a part of earlier in the year. What has his support been like? What have interactions with him been like?
To start off, he's a very chill guy to be with, and he's very fun. So, I mean, there wasn't much difficult for me to approach him or something like that. He was very supportive, to be honest, and I look up to him. Every Tamil Nadu cricketer coming from, from all the parts of Tamil Nadu will obviously look up to him. He has played a lot of cricket for country and everything. So he's been a massive support for me.
And the IPL, you may not have got the full KKR experience yet, but you spent some time at the academy early this year with Abhishek Nair. How was that experience for you?
Firstly, I haven't met him before, so I was a bit, I didn't know how to approach him and something like that. And when I went there, he was very approachable. He guided me. I mean, the team were very supportive. They were like a family, to be honest. I felt like home, seriously.
Yeah, and you also got a chance to meet a lot of your teammates, Rinku, Nitish, Sandeep. How did you get along with them? How was that experience meeting them?
As I said, I haven't played with them before. It's just this year I've started playing with all of them, and they were very welcoming, to be honest. They were very fun, they were very chill. So it was, I didn't feel anything like that. I felt like a home.
Anyone in particular you built a particularly strong friendship with?
Sandeep Warrior and Prasid Krishna, to be honest. They are, I didn't know I'll get along with them so well. So yeah.
You said that your father used to play cricket and he inspired you to pick up the sport. But where did the spin bowling interest begin? How did how did your journey truly start?
To be honest, I wanted to be a fast bowler. I started off a fast bowler, and one of my coaches told you haven't had so much pace, you don't have so much pace to bowl. So he changed me to a spinner, and after that it came along well, I didn't know.
So did your father have a say in what whether you'd be a bowler, batsman, spin, or did he leave it up to your coaches entirely?
He didn't actually come into that aspect very much. He left everything to the coach. I used to bat well also in my childhood, and once I started taking wickets a lot, it became like a bowler who can bat. So it happened like that.
Okay, and when we spoke to you earlier about the KKR Academy, one thing that you said not once but twice was that you felt welcome and KKR feels like a family. What experiences, any particular anecdote or one instance that may have happened with you that you recall where you remember feeling that, yes, I truly feel like I am a part of this family now?
There was a get-together in Nayas's place. So we all were there and everyone gelled very well there. Everyone were very welcoming, and my Venki sir was also there, so it was truly, very special for me that day.
When you talk about spin bowling versus big hitters, especially in a format as dynamic as T20s, was there any specialized training or any focus areas that you worked on in the KKR Academy to face big hitters?
I was just there for 4 days or something, so I just worked on my skill. I couldn't work a lot on how to bowl there. I just worked on my skill and I had to come back because of the virus something.
When you walk into a KKR dressing room, especially this year with so many big and impactful players in that dressing room alongside you, were you particularly excited to meet somebody and probably exchange notes on the spot or say something too?
I think it'll be Andre Russell. I think I've been seeing a lot of sixes from everything out of the park, so it'll be really nice interacting with him.
Yeah, have you decided what you might say to him when you first see him or how you'd initiate conversation with him?
At this moment, I haven't thought anything. Maybe when I go there, something I'll do.
And have you planned maybe what you'll bowl to him in the nets?
I have, but seeing him hit a lot of sixes, I don't know whether it'll be correct for him or whether the plan will be correct for him. I don't know.
And then turning things around, having Andre bowl to you. What would you rather pick? Andre bowling to you and you batting, or you bowling to Andre in the nets?
Andre bowling to me.
Yeah? You think you'd be able to hit him for some big sixes?
I think bowling to him would be a bit of a tough task than me batting than to him.
Okay, you're picking up the easier option basically.
Yeah.
Okay, playing under 14 cricket for your state and then making your IPL debut with a franchise as big as the Kolkata Knight Riders, did you imagine growing up that this would be the start to your career? You also played in the Syed Mushtaq Ali for Tamil Nadu. Did you imagine that this would happen to you one day, or was it all part of the plan?
I've always dreamt of playing the higher level and playing the IPL. I've always dreamt of, even when the IPL started, I was very passionate about cricket, that I used to draw all the logos of the teams and players and everything. So I've always wanted to be there, and it's just a start for me, and I'm really happy for that and very grateful. I'm looking forward for the next thing.
You used to draw the logos of the team, so you're an artist as well?
I wouldn't say that, but I can draw a bit, so yeah.